Do you dread old age and fear death? Good morning, everyone. This is our reflection question for today.
There you are, looking just the same as you did last time I touched you.
Wilt u misschien onze proefritje maken?
Nu tijdelijk de Volkswagen Edition modellen. Standaard met heel veel extra's en extra voordelige prijs.
Today's reading on Ecclesiastes dwells on the subject of aging. In the Old Testament, prior to the flood that drowned the world, people lived above 900 years old. Adam was 930 and Noah was 950 and Methuselah was 960 before they expired. Even Abraham at 175 and Moses at 120 would outlive many of us in today's more health-conscious world. But in the Jewish tradition, old age was a reward given by God to those who led good lives. I was then attending a wedding anniversary celebration of a couple when I spotted their 92-year-old father seated happily enjoying the banquet and the program. I asked him what was the secret of his growing old, healthy and lucid. Well, he said, simple life, simple problems. Kohelet, which means teacher in Hebrew and in Greek is translated into Ecclesiastes, in today's reading, advises the young to learn as they enjoy their youth. Otherwise, there will only be regrets for missed opportunities. There will be abiding fear of death, and life will be a slow motion heading towards our final days before our bodies will return to the dust of the earth. But there is no denying that we are all just passing through. Life is short and fragile, and thus we must make use of our time here on earth to live it well. We will experience a variety of emotions, with anxiety and depression as staples for the hardships, failures, and missteps that may come. But Kohelet advises that we need to live meaningful and happy lives. We can prepare well for the future afterlife and the promise it holds. We must appreciate what life can teach us. Agatha Christie, famous mystery writer and best-selling novelist of all time, once said of her husband, "I married an archaeologist because the older I grow, the more he appreciates me." In our old age, we may have lost the strength, the agility, and the energy of our youth. But the positive flip side is that we have grown wiser, more emotionally stable, more mature, because life is a great teacher. We are not as impulsive as before. We take measured steps, literally and figuratively, because we have the benefit of hindsight. In today's responsorial psalm, there is one verse that caught my eye. "Teach us how short our life is, so that we may become wise." Indeed, for a good number of people, they would live to a ripe old age if their life was not spent so focused on earning, providing, and accumulating wealth to the detriment of other things more important, such as their marriages and their children. They never know when to stop. In any case, there should be no regrets as we journey to the last terminal of life, only gratitude. It is not anymore a question of how much longer, but how much better we can live it that must preoccupy our minds. A blessed life is a life blessed with deep human relationships through the years, through our fears and tears. The longest study on old age conducted by Harvard University, spanning 80 or so years across many generations and multiple researchers throughout its life, has confirmed that our longevity rests on our treasured relationships that accompany us throughout. We must savor every moment of life too, in solitude, through prayer, and a deep relationship with our God. By preparing our souls well, death is not to be feared, but the afterlife is to be eagerly anticipated. We are ready to go anytime if our faith is nurtured and our souls are constantly nourished. We cannot predict when we shall take our last breath. We can only begin to breathe life into every day by taking care of our souls. Let us pray. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Heavenly Father, let me take every step of my life with judicious care for my soul. It is in life that I discover that death is my gateway to a beautiful afterlife, and fear I must not. This I pray in Jesus' holy and mighty name. Amen. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. God bless your families, brothers and sisters. God bless our Catholic faith and Couples for Christ.